this thing is on. I don't know, sometimes I don't know if it's recording or I don't. And I know when it's recording, I just don't look. And I end up talking to myself. Thursday, July 28, 2022. It's 6:56. Yeah, 6:56 in the morning. And then I got distracted. Anyway, yeah, I got off out of my house at like 10 after 5. Like, you know, I've been doing it this past couple of weeks. With the surgery and stuff, I just cannot take the heat also, you know. On top of that, you know, it's a lot. It's a lot for me. I went to the beach one time. I had fun, but anyway, the weather this week has been pretty bad. You know, like, you know, cloudy, raining. Like, today it's gonna rain as well, so I can make sure I come early, you know, to get my workout done. I wanna be well ready. It's only been, it's gonna be 3 months only. It's only gonna be 3 months. And what can I tell you? I'm in pain. Like, discomfort, and just like, I just feel like it make me cranky. But I'm like, and I'm very happy too at the same time. Very happy. But I know I still got like 9 more months to go. 9 more months. I mean, that's what everybody said. Everybody said that. I thought those flowers were real. I was like, and yeah, it's working out center over here. So I mean, I have. It's like, I want to have a talk with all these guys, wives, and girlfriends. Like, this guy, bro. Like, so many guys just chase me just from Dykeman over here, you know, to Jerome. And, you know, so I have this guy, very good looking, but they turned me off in the middle of the day. You know, I'm half Italian. I was gonna say, what the hell is that, Italian? Italian is not a race. It's a nationality. It's like always you find all these idiots, you know, like there's another guy who's a leftist, you know, he's a young guy on YouTube, and you say, oh, I'm half Syrian, half British. You know, so like, what the hell is that? You're black. We're all black. You know, only what, like 50, 60 years ago, they were still enforcing, you know, the one drop rule. Got another bug. One drop rule, which is true, because that's how dominant the original DNA it is. You're not gonna be like, yeah, you might be able to get one or two generations to come up pale, but sooner or later. Well, I mean, like, also the food, everything is designed to attack, you know, the pineal gland. You know, they call it the third eye, which is the first eye. And that's, you know, part of a very important part, you know, with the pituitary and stuff, to produce melanin, the pigmentation, to process carbon. Actually, a carbonated people is very important, so that's like, you know, coming out pale. You know, it's just everything is strategic, and then the things they put over here that also target that. The water got tons of fluoride. I mean, you name it, I can be here, you know, all this stuff that is designed to people to come out pale. That's like, but nobody wanna listen. People are like, I'm crazy, but okay. And it's like so dangerous, especially right now. Like, you know, we see like all these crazy things, all these mysterious fires. Some people, they say they just started. So fires, I don't know. There's a video that went viral. I was like, I don't buy those things. There's so much fakery, you know. I don't buy it at all. But you gotta question. There's a video, I think, I don't know. Well, it's somewhere, I think it's Sri Lanka, no, Pakistan, something like that. And supposedly this guy in the store, you know, the whole store burned down, everybody died. But somehow the camera survived or something, I don't know. So they see the camera and see this guy start lighting up. He lit up. He got lit. Bien prendido. Bien prendido. That's how our African American brothers and sisters, I think they came out with that, you know, lit. Since I can remember, you know, so, bien prendido. So, I mean, there's this weird stuff going on around because, you know, now what they're gonna say, still not Aquarius, still is not the era of Aquarius fully. You know, it was waiting for Pluto to go the whole around the galaxy or something. I don't know, it's like so much BS. It's like, but you feel it, you know, like white boy magic. It's not happening, it's not working. Like they used to be like, you know, no matter what, it was like winning for real, not just like Trump. They say like winning, like Charlie Sheen, winning, you know, winning. That's Biden right now. We're winning. No, he cannot even say that. I mean, if he said that, I mean, he probably do say that, you know, because we allow them to get away with murder every day, every moment. You know, as I was watching, you know, about Jerome Powell, you know, just talking about that, just a little bit more unemployment. But everybody, all the crackers, they are demanding blood. Unfortunately, in order to get better, unemployment got to get a lot worse. Because it's like, they don't even talk about underemployment, right? They don't talk about underemployment. You know, everybody's underemployed. I mean, like, come on, not everybody, but a lot of them. Like, you know, these African American women, they all got college degrees and stuff like that. And they gotta work these bullshit jobs, you know. I mean, they are not prepared. That's the reason why they have to work those bullshit jobs. I mean, I've seen it myself. I've seen it. My clinic. They don't even know how to spell. Supposedly they have college degrees. How you got your college degree? Oh, that's right. It was on the microphone, right? Open mic. And but you know, they're all up to here in debt. Because, oh, I want a new outfit. A new outfit. I want a new this, a new that. So, no savings. And, you know, and people, they're so stupid too that they allow them to. They allow them to be like, the truth is that they are all operating in the red. 90% of them, they are operating in the red. They got loans, student loans still to pay, and they're still taking out credit cards. They're still like, you know, like, no wonder they're so bitter as hell. You know, they're like, they walk around like, you know, I don't know. I don't know how long this bullshit's gonna last. Because now there's the internet, people can look it up to see, you know, oh, so you're a bad bitch, right? Okay. Let's see. Let's see. You know, like all these feminists, like, you got so much debt, you're underemployed, you spend all this money to get this degree, and they won't hire you because of practice. That's what they do. Like, you know, like people who work out. You know, business administration. I don't know. That's what they used to call it when I was younger. And they used to call it business, whatever. For what? You know, like, you know, the peons are not going to let you administrate their job. So they are like, you know, glorified receptionist or whatever, you know. That's it. You know, like, there's tons of, you know, what they call, like, home care, whatever, health care aides, whatever the same, glorify housekeeper. You know, but they wear scrubs. Come on, they're wearing scrubs. And it's like, just to think about it, like, you know, you go in somebody's house, yikes, to wipe their ass. That's progress. You sustain your house and, you know, you can work from your house, do some other stuff, you know. Yesterday I forgot, you know, I came to from my workout and I got very tired, like right now, like I couldn't sleep last night. And, you know, my cat either, he couldn't sleep much either, my cat. And he's an Aries too. He's from March 30th and I'm from April 6th. That's how I know. That's how I know, like, I'm not the only one. It might be something going on. A lot to reflect on. I've been unpacking some family stuff, which I have done before. It's just like every time I do it, it's just like, wow, like, who are these people? Who are these people? And oh my God, are they all, you know, super Catholic, super this, super that? And you ask them, they're like the greatest people in the world. Never even call me to see, like, not because, you know, when I give, that's it. I don't worry, there's no price tag, there's no strings attached, there's no nothing. I learned a long time ago that, I mean, people reciprocate, but in different ways and different times, and, you know, of course, when we reciprocate, we think our reciprocation is worth $1 billion, right? Oh, we're set, right? We're set. You know, I say good morning this today, you know, so I don't know you nothing, because saying good morning from me is worth $1 million. I mean, I'm exaggerating, but we tend to be like, as people, I mean, I noticed that, you know, when I was young, I was like, I noticed like people. Because, you know, it's like, I thought it was going to be like, okay, this is how society works, and like, so that's all right. That's all right, because one of my main goals in life is not to, you know, become bitter. Because I see that. I feel like there's so many good teachers around, walking around, you know, and that they remind me, like, well, right now, you know, this guy, he was already here. He was already coming here. You know, he was, you know, rolling the blunt and stuff. He started talking to me. He had to tell me that he was half Italian. So we started talking, telling me, like, you know, he used to have, you know, I don't know. I suspect it was transgender. I don't know. I told him, you know, I'm post-op. You know, there's nothing, you know. And he's still one of my phone number, like, whatever. He seemed to be a little bit He told me he did also like 7 years in the federal. He said he met El Chapo. He said he met El Chapo. So like, yeah, he said if he was to come around, nobody would recognize him. He lost a lot of weight. He just, like, looked very different now. I don't know if it's true, whatever. You know. Very handsome guy, very tall, very, you know, the typical, you know, tall, dark, and handsome. I don't know, sometimes you're in the mood or whatever. Okay, I gave him my number. I just block him. That's it. I said sometimes I think they're just hunters and they just want a phone number or something. Yeah, I score a phone number. You know. I mean, I gave him the Obama phone and they want to find out my address or anything, so. But we was here for like 15, not even 15 minutes. So, you know, it's like some, you know, old ladies passing by and say, good morning. They all went like, I don't want to be that. I don't want to be that. Like, shit don't cost a thing. Say good morning. Good morning, like, you know, that's a shit don't cost a thing. I know, it's like, but come on, you know, a public park and there's a lot of people here. So, when I went to the ATM, because surprisingly I got my money one day early, I was supposed to get it tomorrow. So I went there and, you know, this African American woman, like, she came in and, you know, there's a guy who sit outside opening the door for some coins, you know. I was like, a couple quarters. Oh, she couldn't shut up. She was like, yeah, the boss, like, everybody's asking you for shit. I'm like, whatever. Don't give him shit. I mean, like, you know, he's always there. You know, not always, but I've seen him before. You know, I've seen him over there before. He's seen over there. You know, now there's women doing that too. You know, they're like, because we are copycats, right? You know, they say, oh, we're doing that. It's, I mean, it just looks silly to see a woman like opening the door. I don't know, I guess it's so used to, especially here in New York City. And she couldn't shut up, like, whatever. Like, oh, come on. As if you was innocent, you know, shit is horrible. Shit is like, oh my God, the Bronx is a word, blah, 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 blah. It's like, but who's raising the children? Not African American men, sure. But they get it locked up like this. Oh, I got born, I got whatever, or peace, whatever. You know, I don't want nobody to be telling me nothing. So what they do? Call 911 and say, oh, he beat me up. That's it. He got locked up. You get a divorce, whatever, and oh, poor woman. Yes, he lied to me. He did whatever, like, you know. And then you find out they never even dated. You didn't even date it. They don't even date no more. They just go with whatever, you know, like, I'm like, well, you got what you deserve. Ah, you don't understand. They don't want to do that. They like, whatever. There's no man is going to wait, like, whatever. It's like, well, that's what you said. You can, there's other ways. There's many ways. When we want, we can be very resourceful. When we don't want, it's like, oh. It's like, you know, we gotta go. We gotta move in together. Because now you don't even gotta be married to get alimony. You can just say, well, it's 5 years or 3 years, I think it's 3 years, and now he gotta give me some money. And the guy make a lot less than she do, but still, you know, just because it's a crazy world that we live in, you know. So don't try and tell me that it's men's fault. When, you know, men are not even part of the house. They're not in the house. And if they are in the house, then they're simps. They're like, you know, always they got to back off because
emancipate yourselves from
mental. I mean that's a man that's not gonna be like back and forth with you. Unless he's gay. Then he's gonna be like arguing all the time. So it's like, so
how long shall they heal our prophets?
So he's smoking his blunt, and the guy who works over here at the gym, they're like, oh, can you smoke over there because it's coming in the gym? Like, this is the Bronx, this is the damn ghetto. The man is like, why are you trying to be like, are you serious? I mean, like, just look around. I don't even want to show you. They don't even wash the tables, like, can tell, like, in 20 years, I don't even like garbage everywhere and stuff like that. So it's like, if we, you know, I just feel like if there wasn't so much satanization of Bud, you know, like, the world would have been different.
Emancipate yourself from mental.
Because alcohol is, well, my father was a pothead. I think they're like, but I don't hear nobody saying nothing about alcohol. It's always Bud, you know, my gosh. You pothead, you this, you that, you whatever. And they're like, I mean, I compare to, I think they're the most calm people. I mean, I smoke too sometimes, I'm gonna say, but sometimes, you know, don't feel like it. I mean, I don't. I guess there's some people that do develop a, you know, kind of codependency, a little crutch, especially the people who have PTSD. But to me, it's not the greatest thing for me. I mean, sometimes when you need it, you need it. But for me, like, I'm not really crazy about it. You know, I appreciate it. I appreciate it. But, you know, and it's about what you want to make it. It's about what you want to make it. So here, there's a couple that they are just walking. Yeah, I never seen a man walk. You know, for exercise, you know, the one that we do, like, when we feel guilty, we wanna, you know, work out, we just go walking in the park, like, you see, like, there's a man that's running. You see, he's with his wife and everyone walking. But now you see that everywhere, they're matching, they were matching everything. Like, back in the 70s, you know, the unisex, and, like, there's no genders, there's no, like, and it shows, and it shows, like, neighborhoods are a mess. Neighborhoods are really bad. Surgery hurt. I'm crashing. I woke up and it's like, oh God. I didn't want to look at the time because sometimes, like, I don't want to look at the time. Just, and I couldn't go back to sleep. And then that's when I realized that it must have been like 11:30. Yeah, it was like 12 when I woke up. I couldn't go back to sleep. I guess then after a couple of hours, I guess I could have been like crashing, but I said, like, well, it's gonna be raining and it's gonna get worse, you know, because my apartment, I put it on the money saving mode. At night it was okay, but this morning it, like, got really stuffy, my apartment. So when I come back, I just have to turn it on and put it like a regular mode. Oh, now I'm crashing. I hope I can take a little nap. Oh no, I gotta go to acupuncture. Let me see if they open already. Only 7:20. They might be open. They might have a cancellation. So I can go right now. It might help me to sleep because the last couple of days, I've not been able to sleep. You know, very well. How much is this? 32%. Oh well. Africa unite. Sit down. Moving right out of Babylon. How fast can I be there?
Okay, sorry. Being your representative, you're on the line. How good and pleasant it would be before
God and man. To see the unification of trying to get battery charged, but they keep turning on the Wi-Fi. So the one they give you is supposed to be on limited data. I'm like, I don't even know this. I don't even put the Wi-Fi on. In an accessible, I put it like in the back. I'm not gonna use the Wi-Fi. They say they give you unlimited data, it's unlimited data. Last month I only got like 9 gigabytes. They cut it off. They say they give you 2 more.